upstairs from you. Yes, I think you've seen me before. If you hear something late at night, some kind of troublesome kind of fight, just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. Just don't ask me what it was. And they only hit until you cry. After that, you don't ask why. You just don't argue anymore. Just don't argue anymore. Just don't argue anymore.
When I am old, running and dreaming back through time, I'll still thank God for giving me a love like yours and mine. This world can break your body, tear dreams apart, but deep in the darkest hour, a miracle can start. When I am old, darling, and dreaming back through time, I'll still thank God for giving me a love like yours and mine. You don't take me for granted. You don't try to hold me down. You want to see me happy. You love me the way I am. When I am old, darling, and dreaming back through time, I'll still thank God for giving me a love like yours and mine.
Hello, and thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you all for joining us online and virtually. Finally, it's here, our 9th annual cancer concert for cancer relief. Happy to have these well-known people. Lovely Don Richmond. Miss Eliza Gilkyson. And Miss Tish Hinojosa. It's wonderful to see all the support that's coming to the San Luis Valley Cancer Relief Fund. There are many, many people that appreciate what you do to help them get through some rough patches. We all know them personally, by our family, our friends, and our neighbors, our community, and we couldn't keep supporting them without you. We've been doing this for quite some time. My name's Sophia Avila. I'm the president this year. I've been with the Cancer Relief Fund since 2012, following the year my father passed away, and I have been here for the last 10 years. Miss Terry McCarthy has led the way to make me continue having this come to our community and to support us. This year, we were excited that we were able to increase our stipend awards to $350 per recipient. And it's a blessing to see what it can do to them and help them on their journey. So we ask you up front to keep your masks up to for the safety of our musicians. There are refreshments in the back. You guys have flyers in your hands for our website. If you'd like to donate more, there are also envelopes. And as well, online, you can go to our website and donate there. So without further ado, let's get the show on the road and have a great evening. Enjoy.
I'm kind of seeing you as being sort of Captain Trips.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll you know what
out.
I'm saying?
I'll
okay.
Yeah.
Well, thank you all so much for being here and for being part of this magical evening, because they've all been magical, and I know that this one will exceed all the rest as far as I'm concerned. So honored to be here with these two wonderful singer-songwriters. Just they are songwriting royalty, and I tell you, it's a wonderful thing. Eliza and Tish, I've known them both for a lot of years, and they both have deep roots in this area, and we've been so looking forward to trading songs and just enjoying the evening with you all. I'm going to kick it off, and let's see, just a second here. And you know, I decided that just to make sure that the evening starts at this one place and then it just goes up from there, I'm going to start with the banjo. You know, I mean, you're just going to... Anyway, I like banjos. But this is a springtime song, which is really why I'm playing it. And, you know, this is... Right now is the Crane Festival time, so the cranes are back. It was an utterly gorgeous day today, and you know, life looks pretty good when all that's happening, as far as I'm concerned. So this is a little love song. It's on one of the old Rifters albums. It's a song I wrote with a little help from one of the guys in that band, from Steve Carey. It's a love song, but it's called Cranes. Today I caught the scent of earth as if for the first time, and the cranes are calling me from far above. Watched you throw open the window to the warm breeze, and I give thanks for life and for your love. Like the cranes that still return from the bosque to bring the spring back up the Rio Grande. Like the water that runs down to the Acequia to spread the green across the bottom land. Like the quickening of life and light return that calls the seed to awaken and grow. So your love for me is like the springtime and the sunshine that melts the winter snow. I've been alone and I've seen the winter, but now I got another chance. Spring has come and I can start anew. And as the earth circles the sun and the never-ending dance, I give thanks the one I spin around is you. Like the cranes that still return from the bosque to bring the spring back up the Rio Grande. Like the water that runs down to the Acequia to spread the green across the bottom land. Like the quickening of life and light returning that calls the seed to awaken and grow. So your love for me is like the springtime and the sunshine that melts the winter snow. As long as the blood still fills the rivers in this body and I can find the breath to speak your name, I will celebrate the seasons of this lifetime that are the rhythms of the song our love proclaims. Like the cranes that still return from the bosque to bring the spring back up the Rio Grande. Like the water that runs down to the Acequia to spread the green across the bottom land. Like the quickening of life and light return that calls the seed to awaken and grow. So your love for me is like the spring. The sunshine that melts the winter snow. Yes, your love for me is like the springtime and the sunshine that melts the winter snow. Oh, thank you. Gotta love those cranes, you know. Boy, they've been here for about 3 or 4 weeks now. As soon as I hear them flying overhead, it's like, ah, spring is happening, spring is happening. May I introduce to you Miss Eliza Gilkyson, singing a song. Yeah.
This guy is so amazing. I know you already know this, but he really is amazing. What a beautiful song. And I don't think I even know that song. What's that from?
It's on it's called Cranes. It's on the first Rifters album.
That's another beauty. Mm-hmm. All right, well, you may or may not know that Don just produced my latest record, Songs from the River Wind, and he's playing all over it. People are asking me, who are all those great players? Like, yeah, this one guy.
There are a few others.
There's a few others, yeah. But I'm going to do this song that's on the record. But this is I took an old Irish folk song from the 1800s, late 1800s, that was called Wanderin', and it was a beautiful song. You might know other incarnations of this song. There have been many of them over the last 100 plus years. So this is my version. I thought, you know, all these other versions were by men, and I thought, you know, there's women wanderers too. So I'm gonna do a wandering from the woman's point of view. My daddy was a song man. My mother broke his heart, and the road was always calling from the very start. And it looks like cease my wandering. Oh, I've been a wanderer. I roam from town to town, singing for my supper with no thoughts of settling down. And it looks like I'm never gonna cease my wandering. Guitar man in Austin, a friend in Santa Fe, and a cowboy up in Jackson who tempted me to stay. But it looks like I'm never gonna cease my wandering. From the Brazos to the Badlands, along the Rio Grande I've roamed, winding round the road bends, rolling like a stone.
Miss Tish Hinojosa. So thrilled to have you here, Tish.
That was so lovely.
I heard you singing. Oh, that made me so happy. I just love this woman so much. She's so talented.
We haven't seen each other in a long time.
Yeah.
So it's a nice reunion here
tonight.
So you're talking about wandering, and here's a wandering song as well. This is a Spanish song I wrote many years ago. It's called Corazón Viajero, The Wandering Heart. And let me see, I had hand surgery, and so this is the first time I'm actually playing, so hopefully it's gonna work.
Persona en cualquier lugar sabe un cuento de amores. se guarda dentro para recordar, y así se pasan los dolores. Cuando los días de su fiel pasar regresan a reconocer, ahí te espero, pero primero este cuento de un soñar. Sin dar razón se dio pasión, el corazón viajero, destino fue a conocer que juventud no es juego. Se me pasó el tú y yo, inocencia cambiará, pero si aprenden cruzar los puentes de las lágrimas que dan.
Here's a lalas.
La 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 la. Sin dar razón se dio pasión, el corazón viajero, destino fue a conocer que juventud no es juego. Se me pasó el tú y yo, inocencia cambiará, se aprenden cruzar los puentes de las lágrimas que dan. Desde aquí quiero recontar cariño que yo conocí, y sin embargo el tiempo ha de pasar, pues los recuerdos son así. Pensarán los que lo saben más, que todo el mundo es igual. Padres, abuelos, blancos, morenos, saben los cuentos que yo vi. Padres, abuelos, blancos, morenos, saben los cuentos que yo vi.
Thank you.
How lovely.
Thank you very much. Mr. Don Richmond.
Which instrument is he going to pick up?
What's happening now?
I know. I felt so excessive moving all these instruments in here tonight. You know, But this one might be nice on that one song. Anyway, I'm going to do a brand new song that I've played it for my friends in the Rifters, and I played it for Eliza's songwriting workshop. But that's the only time I played it out at all. So let's see. I've got to remember how it goes. Okay. You know, I've noticed as I've grown older that I've started to write more songs about growing older. And that's what this one is about. It's called It's 'Cause You Lived. You look in the mirror and wonder why the hair is gray and the skin is lined and the eyes are tired from all they've seen. They've lost some vision and some dream. It's 'cause you lived. It's 'cause you took the chance and did the dance. 'Cause you didn't shirk the duty or the work. And though you couldn't guess, you said yes. And you gave everything you had to give. It's 'cause you lived. Back talks back as you get out of bed. And the knees speak of every chase you led. And you wonder why your heart so steady for so long is now dancing to some different song. It's 'cause you lived. It's 'cause you took the chance, did the dance. 'Cause you didn't shirk the duty or the work. And though you couldn't guess, you said yes. And you gave everything you had to give. It's 'cause you lived. Yet you still drink deep from the eyes of a child for that part of you still young and wild. Oh, it's 'cause you lived. 'Cause you took the chance and did the dance. 'Cause you didn't shirk the duty or the work. Though you couldn't guess, you said yes, and you gave everything you had to give. It's 'cause you lived. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
A great song.
Mm-hmm.
Now I don't know what to do because I don't have a song about living. let's see, I do have Well, this one might qualify. Let's see. Is that a key right there, or is that a flat? Is that
an E?
That's E, okay. That's what I was hoping. This is sort of a... This is sort of a living song. I remember I wrote it. I know mushrooms were involved. It was a long time ago, but I remember, you know, sort of one of those long nights, and at the end of it, there was this song. Through the looking glass, into another world where all is still. Majestic silence calls me, and I will walk on. Through the looking glass, reaching for a place my eyes can't see. Wandering in the nighttime where I'll be at dawn. Walking on and on through the green. Fields and the minefields to learn how love feels on this ocean. This mirror of my heart, the great devotion game. Beauty beckons like a pot of gold. Once upon a time, I walked a road like this. Through the looking glass, crossing the dark waters of my loneliness, living for the glimpses of life's holiness. Through the looking glass, stars don't have to tell me where to go. I've lived enough to know I want the whole of love. Walking on and on through the green fields and the minefields to learn how love feels on this ocean. This mirror of my heart, the great devotion game. Beauty beckons like a pot. We haven't played that probably in about 4 years, so that was a pretty good memory there, old guy.
Oh, well, it's in there somewhere.
It's a different part of your brain that remembers songs, fortunately for us.
Let's see, what am I going to do now?
Yeah. You can change the topic if you want, but
yes.
Yeah, feel free.
Yeah, you know what? Well, couple of things. So it's wonderful to be back in this little beautiful corner of the world. I love this place and northern New Mexico, and my husband and I just traveled down from, well, from Austin to Evergreen, and gosh, I hadn't been in the mountains in quite a while, so what an adventure. And we love it. I love it. So this song is going to take me back to my days of when I lived in between Red River and Taos. And I was a city girl from San Antonio when I first moved to the mountains back in 79. And I didn't know anything about cowboys or country music. Or, you know, I really was pretty much a city girl. And until I met Rod Taylor. I learned a lot about cowboying and a great appreciation for the art of the cowboy. And so this city girl wrote a song called It's the Way of Life in the Real West. And the Rifters do a great version of it. It's the way of life in the real West, 'neath the prairie moon that's heaven blessed, and a tall boot shuffle on a wooden floor. It's a clean white shirt on a Saturday night, and a long cold beer is pure delight. And if you heard me say it, there's a whole lot more. City girl, but I must confess I'd be a cowboy angel, and I know what for. It's the way of life in the real West, where your time is yours when the sun sets and the stars rise up to light the western sky.
Great song. Well, let's see. My turn again, huh? Well, I had the first two songs pick out, and I'll have to think about it. But Well, last
late last summer, I put out a solo CD, which is something I do rarely. I love to write songs, and I write, depending on, sometimes I write a lot of songs, sometimes I don't, I write songs that the Rifters do, but I write songs that don't really fit the band and that are more personal for whatever reason, or just aren't good enough, or who knows what, I feel like I have to give those songs a home, and so I do solo albums, and I do love to play that repertoire out and play solo gigs and stuff, but I don't do it very often because up until everything shut down, the Rifters stayed pretty busy, and I really didn't have a lot of space and time and energy to go out doing a lot of solo gigs. So anyway, when COVID hit, I really I wrote a bunch of songs, and so it was a double CD. It's like a true overdose of Don Richmond songs. If you really get into it. But anyway, I'm going to do a song off of that one. I do have my little gadget here that I can look at things if I really need to. I knew these songs back last summer when I sang them out, but I haven't sung them much since then. This is a love song. Because love is a good thing.
Yeah.
It's called Another Language. I need another language when I talk to you. The words are all faded, they've been so overused. You're beautiful, I love you, will no longer do. I need another language to speak of loving. I need another language of light and shooting stars, of morning mist and gossip, of feather touch upon. Cataclysmic silence, the soul's poetry. I need another language to speak of knowing, like the laughter of the water, the singing of the sea, music of the morn, the evening's mystery. That spark of living luminance dancing in your eyes, the treasure of a trusting heart, a gift so far above. I need another language to speak of such a love. Thank you.
That's beautiful. That is just beautiful. We could do love songs.
Love songs, there you go.
We could go there. Let's see. It was so much easier, you know, when we were young to write love songs about, you know, angst kind of love. But it's harder to write like deep love songs. It's not as harder, it's more challenging, I should say. Because it's going to a whole other place. And man, I tell you, with COVID, you know, you got to love the one you're with. You know, it's like. I've been with my husband now for 16 years, but we were both in like two different worlds all the time. And it was like when COVID came and we were suddenly living together like all the time, doing everything together. It was like, thank God, I actually really like this guy. You know, I thought I did, but I wasn't sure until, yeah.
Thank you.
lovely.
I mean, he hasn't played these songs with me in like years, and I didn't tell him I was going to do this song. It's so pretty, Don. Nice, nice.
We're so lucky. Y'all are so lucky to have Don Richmond here.
Yeah. I say that every time I play here. I go, you know how lucky you are.
Well, we're on the subject of love. I do have some love songs, but I'm going to tell you a love story and then kind of a love song. The song is going to be a love song to my guitar, who's been my loyal companion since 1992. Well, yeah, thank you. Thank you. but here's the love story. The love story is that this guitar means a lot to me. And there was a period of time I lived in Germany for about 10 years. And I was married to a German, and, you know, things went well for a little while. And then they didn't. And then they didn't. So I came back pretty brokenhearted to Austin. And so it was about 2013 or so, somewhere around there. Anyway, what had happened was that I had a rock and roll moment, and I was so angry at my husband that I broke my guitar. I know, this little treasure, I said, man, it should have been him, not the guitar. But anyway, so all that, I was so overwhelmed with, and I put my guitar in the closet, and I didn't touch it for like 7 years. Or no, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 8, okay, 5 years. Anyway, so then one day I just decided I'm going to do something about this guitar. I'm too. I just felt inspiration one morning. I pulled it out of the closet, went to Home Depot and got wood clamps and glue. And I said, I'm just going to fix it myself. And it was kind of a heart repairing and the guitar repairing all at the same time, kind of putting ourselves both back together again. And so it was pretty beat up. I mean, it was really badly beat up. But the glue worked. I can't believe that I actually made it. I put it back together, and then I put strings on it, and then it, you know, it was kind of, it wasn't very attractive, but it worked. And anyway, so then in 2018, 2017, I was inspired to, because of the song that I wrote for this, I immediately wrote about 8 more and then made a record called West. And,
great record.
And then, to further the love story, I'm going to try to make it shorter. But then love came back into my life, and it was a long, long time friend. We'd been friends since 1990 or so, I guess. And life just kind of brought us back together again. And so he took this guitar that I kind of sort of repaired, but then it didn't work. The glue didn't hold for that long. He actually took it into his little wood shop, and he totally built it back and better and even stronger. So
wow.
My sweetheart, Lynn.
Wow.
We called him Geppetto. So here's my little love song to the guitar, but it also talks about how he helped me put myself together, and then he put my guitar together, and, you know, what a guy. And on the COVID front, yeah. Also, because, like, we're together 24/7 all during COVID, and it's like, we must really like each other.
Yeah. You better.
So this is called My Good Guitar. You've traveled well. You've traveled far. We've loved each other for what we are. And soared through space, Venus and Mars. Past the sun, straight to the stars. We've lived our songs in city bars and hotel rooms. Sidekick above it all, my steady friend, my good guitar.
You look like me. I look like you. We've been through hell. We've fallen hard. I've picked up pieces and glued the shards. And music flows through cracks and scars. It's you and me, my good guitar.
Take a little break. These nights go by so fast. I always want five more rounds. No. We'll do one more round and then we'll take a break, and then we'll come back for some more. So.
Yeah, you need some more instruments over there.
Let's see, I had a request for this song that song from the Rifters Band. I love living in the wide open of the San Luis Valley. Just never get tired of it. I swear, every time I go outside my door, it's like, wow. And that's sort of what this song is about. I'm kind of addicted to it. And sometimes, I mean, the song works on a metaphorical level too, because sometimes it seems like life is just crowding you. There's just too much stuff coming at you, and you need to find a way to kind of rise above it a little bit. Get the longer view. There's a song called 100 Miles. Oh, life's got me surrounded, oh, and oh, I feel confounded by the million things somebody thinks that I should do. But you know, I'm just astounded by this place that I have found, where what once meant so much can seem so little when the day is through. I just want to see all of miles. I just want to see about 100 miles. I just wanna do something that make me smile. I wanna see for 100 miles. Well, I've been told I should deliberate on what I wish to elevate to something that's worth spending my life's hours on. But I seem to deviate from that which most folks consecrate and worship all their days till their days are gone. Cause I just want to see 100 miles. I just want to see 100 miles. I just wanna do some things that make you smile. I wanna see for 100 miles. Well, sometimes the city beckons me, then I sort of reckon I should go see what all of the commotion is about. But when I get to checking, I discover I'm expecting it to chew me up, then just go and spit me out. Cause I just wanna see what I'm doing my. I just wanna see 100 miles. I just wanna do some things that make you smile. I wanna see. Well, I wanna see. Singing, playing. Cool, thank you.
Okay, good night. it's like the ultimate ending song. That's so great. Like, off into the distance they go. And now, wait, there's one more song by Eliza. Wait. Okay, let's see. Okay, well, we've talked about the West. My whole record is about the West, and I just love hearing Tish's songs. Just so long ago, she was so in love with the West, and I think we both had that kindred experience together over the years. So this is one of the songs from the new record, and I took several old cowboy songs and changed them just a little bit so they could be from a woman's standpoint. And this was one of the ones that I did that with.
I think, yeah.
Yeah. I pulled out of Cheyenne, was steaming my kettle and my dancing shoes. Pedal to the metal, gotta get to Washakie before the sun settles. So I dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo gals and pony boys get to congregating down in Old Dubois. Cowboys coming out to make some noise at the Wind River Rendezvous. I danced with a guy with a hole in his sock, and his heels kept rocking, knees kept knocking. Tomorrow morning better do some talking, cause we dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight, come out tonight, come out tonight. Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon. I danced with a guy whose spurs were jingling, the sparks were flying, elbows swinging. Tomorrow morning his head'll still be ringing, cause we dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight, come out tonight, come out tonight. Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon. Let's sing it again. Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight, come out tonight, come out tonight. Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon. And dance by the light of the moon. And dance by the light of the moon. Solo again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Redeem myself.
That little ditty was from a song that Eliza remembered from when she was a little girl going to a ranch up in Wyoming, and she remembers them dancing to that song. And we actually tried to find the name of that song, and
we've asked everybody who knew fiddle songs and everything. Does somebody know that song? Please tell us who wrote it, because we don't have a clue and we're fucked. We can't give credit.
Okay, well, I guess I'm the ender of this set here. So here's another song off West. And, yeah, so... as that last song was from that period also, My Good Guitar. And yeah, this song is about, let me get my... Don, tune my guitar. Tune my guitar for me. I just realized I'm a little bit off here. I know y'all are probably saying, it's time for break. Okay, there we go. Something like that. I'm gonna put the capo on. So this is about life and taking life in stride. And it's a good la-la song. So if you hear la-las, you can sing along. I haven't played in a while. An Italian friend of mine translated the song to Italian, so I think if I remember, I'm going to tag on the little Italian. So if we have any Italians in the audience here tonight, just forgive my Italian, but I love singing it. This is called, I can't remember the name of the song.
It's one of my favorites.
It'll come to me during the song. It starts like this. La la. In the beginning, what did we have to lose? Heaven knows why our circles get closer, dancing in ones and twos over the highway, under the rainbow, shuffling sideways round the blues. Like constellations circling the endless sky, gravity pulls me back to you, taking a leap in the dark with my eyes closed. What are you gonna say? Shadows falling behind us, taking them on our way over the highway, under the rainbow, shuffling sideways round the blues.
Way. Mm-hmm.
pulling sideways round the blues, like constellations circling the endless sky. Gravity pulls me back to you. Gravity pulls me back to you. That's the name of it. Back to you.
Tish Hinojosa, Eliza Gilkyson, Don Richmond. I'm going to take a little break. Feel free to grab a glass of wine or a cookie or whatever else might be back there.
CDs.
Beer,
CDs.
Water. Who knows?
Grab
who knows
some CDs
what,
while you're
who
back
knows
there.
What Pete has behind
the
that bar?
The CDs are there.
Yes, and we do have CDs for sale.
They go well with wine.
Yes.
They pair well with
wine. They pair well, yeah.
Yeah, Tish has got that new album of hers, West, is just fabulous, and I think Eliza's new album is pretty fabulous, too, so hope you'll pick one of those up. And I've got a new one, too. How about that? Anyway, we'll be back in just a few minutes. Stick around.
I climbed across the mountain tops, swam all across the ocean blue, across the screaming loud, it's orange blood, it's wild heart.
just is building up a fight. I'm a stranger in the night. Wind is howling, shaking my bones, shaking my bones, shaking my bones. Thank you.
Stayed in bed all morning just to pass the time. There's something wrong here, there can be no denying. One of us is changing, or maybe we've just stopped trying. And it's too so easy living here with you. You were light and breezy, and I knew just what to do. Now you look so unhappy, and I feel like a fool. And it's too late, baby, now it's too late. Though we really did try to make it, something be good times again for me and you. But we just can't stay together, don't you feel it too? Still, I'm glad for what we had and how I once loved you. But it's too late, baby, now it's too late. Though we really did try to make it, something
hold on to good times, not ticking away. Let us sail through the motions, just me and you, and ride into sunsets like cowboys would do. Cold.
snowflakes at Christmas, cold days shining bright. Let us summit a mountain one step at a time. Sing rain go away like children would rhyme. At least let us try. While you showed a pathway straight to the sky. If sometime come bad times, let me be the one to kiss off your tears like Mama has
All right. Welcome back, everybody. Thanks for sticking around. Hope you enjoyed your chocolate chip cookies dipped in Cabernet Sauvignon. Or whatever you might have. Thank you. you started out, or you wanted to like draw straws or a second round? Or
I could do that.
Change it around?
Let's draw straws. Or somebody flip a coin for us.
Wait.
If it's heads, it's not me.
A three-sided coin.
Right. How do you do that when there's three people? You want to start? Start that end?
Yeah, you know, let's start from this end, because that way, then you can end it.
Yeah, I want.
Okay.
We'll put the ending pressure on Don.
He's an ending professional. I totally agree.
He's an ending professional.
A new job description. All right.
Okay, so here we are. Got a couple of requests during the break, so I'm going to try to play a couple of these in this go-round here. So this is a song I wrote for Mexican cowboy. His name is Chanate, and very famous in South Texas. And anyway, it's this song celebrates the life of the Gulf of Mexico and the landscape and the cowboy. And this is called Chanate el Vaquero. And I'm going to try to, my thumb is still kind of stiff, but I'm going to, hopefully I can do this. Con tu lariata vaquero, en gran caballo y bajo un cielo de azul, échate un grito del alma, como si fuera el alma del aire y del sol. Reátame así un recuerdo con esos ojos en piel de vaqueta y sudor. Es tu sonrisa del cuento, o tal quizás de una historia de un viejo amor. Cambian los tiempos, dicen que el joven no entiende los pasos de ayer. Entre el pasado y el presente, más que el valor al valiente, el que sabe aprender. Siempre vivirás. No desesperes, Chanate, no mueres. Siempre vivirás. Thank you. Kind of feels like a claw. Like, I feel like I'm playing like this.
You're doing great.
You made it.
Okay.
It worked.
I'm gonna do the farthest end.
What's that?
Farthest end.
it's electric.
Electric.
Electric banana. That, I'm going to do the Anglo version of that.
All right.
Yeah. Yes, this, because my record is all about these memories that I have of these people when I was younger, and then loves lost and all through the West. And I think, you know, both of us just writing these records about the West. I've just recently relocated to Taos, and I've just fallen in love with the Southwest again. I mean, I'm like insane. I'm just mad for it. I think I was repressing my desire to come home, and all these years that I've been on the road and I've been living in Austin, and then because of COVID, we moved back here, and then I just freaked out. I was just like, I didn't know I could fall in love with nature all like that again, and so it's been quite a thing. And so all these memories are coming back about people that I've loved, and stories of these amazing people, these Western wonderful cowboys and characters. And so this is one of those people. From hearing his life story, we were riding in the Wind River Range many years ago, and told me some of his story. It's the wrong key, isn't it, Don?
Don knew that.
He was going to go with it. Did you look at him? He was just going to go with it. He's a producer. Change in the weather, riding the range. He got caught in a late winter storm. He was up all night by the firelight, keeping his body warm. He had one cigarette, more than one regret, questions he'd never forget. Where's the farthest end of the deepest sky? Why does my heart still cry? Well, he ran away when he was just a kid. He joined up with the boys in the camp, roped and rode, and he rodeoed. He married the girl on the range. Now there's stock in the bank and stock on the range, and questions of time cannot change. Where's the farthest end of the deepest sky? Why does my heart still cry? Where's the farthest end of the deepest sky? Why does my heart still cry? Thank you.
What pretty little song you gonna do for us now, Mr. Richmond?
Well, I'm gonna do another one off this new record here that, you know, when I talk to people and meet people out in the world and stuff like that, you know, sometimes they'll talk to me about music, but a lot of times they say, boy, you know, I sure like those pictures of the sunrise that you stick on Facebook sometimes. And it's not like I'm a photographer or anything. It's just I happen to live out in, you know, a little northeast of town, and it's wide open around me, and there's nothing but these mountains around. And boy, when the sun comes up over the Sangre de Cristos, it's pretty hard to screw it up, you know? I mean, you go out there and you point your camera and you point your phone, even, and it's like, yeah, that looks pretty cool. So I'm going to do a song about that was kind of inspired by that, I guess. It's called Love Me Like the Morning. Love me like the morning, breaking on the mountain high. Paint me with your colors, like the red and golden sky. Chase away the shadows, warm into my bones. Love me like the morning, love me tonight. I've been walking in the darkness of what might not ever be, scared of something high that I might not see, like something that is under a child's bed at night. But all of it will vanish when your love brings the light. Oh, love me like the morning, breaking on the mountain. Paint me with your colors, like the red and golden sky. Chase away the shadows, warm into my bones. Love me like the morning, love me tonight. Sometimes I feel the sadness of all that seems so wrong, like yearning for the morning star in a night so long. Wondering who I am or just who I should be. But then I feel the sunshine pouring out on me. Oh, love me like the morning, breaking on the mountain high. Paint me with your colors, like the red and golden sky. Chase away the shadows, warm into my bones. Love me like the morning, love me tonight. It's like running in a dream, sinking in the sand. I could be lost forever, but then I feel your hand. The red and golden sky.
shadows warm into my bones. Love me like the morning, love me till I'm home. Love me like the morning, love me till I'm home. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Charlie Moore. Oh no, Trisha, that's great. I'm not next. We'll get a little more time
to
think.
Maybe we go da 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 da. So yeah. Then you'll play every other song.
Yeah.
That's you, darling.
So this is going to work out kind of nicely. I've seen your beautiful pictures of the gorgeous sunrises, and
yes, we all appreciate them in the afternoon when we get up.
we get up. So this is a song about sunrise, and someone was talking to me here during the break, and this is one of my very earliest songs. I wrote this song back in when I lived in Red River, like back in 1980 or something like that. It was my first time living away from home, for one thing, and I just missed my mother terribly, and so I wrote her this song about a sunrise, and this song is something about wishing that wherever they are, they're seeing the same beautiful sunrise, such as the ones that Don posts on his Facebook page. This is called Amanecer, Daybreak. Sueño inquieto se va entre tinieblas de ayer. Despiertas, ves la mañana nacer. Aquel amor lejos de ti está. Silencio de tu soledad, simple melodía deseando a tu vida felicidad, canción de amor a la salida del sol. Por mí. Thank you very much. So I've got a really darling little 2.5-year-old granddaughter. Now I'm just so in love with her. And when she says thank you, she says, thank you too much.
I love those little things that your grandkids say that you end up integrating into your, you know, your adult.
Share it on stage.
My grandson used to say, no me no. And for, you know, years we all go, no me no, you know. It's like an inside language or something. Charlie Moore, shall we? This is another Wyoming memory song that... It's funny because since I put this record out, it's doing really well on Wyoming public radio because there's a lot of Wyoming references, and this song I've had people write me people from Wyoming have written me, who's one guy whose grandfather was close friends with the guy that I wrote the song about. So it's a really iconic person, but in a very small portion of Wyoming and long, long ago. Professional, he's got to have it in tune. We appreciate that. That's right. You know, the whole reason he got into the banjo is because he thought he knew that he'd have a future in a banjo repair.
Well, it's like the old joke goes, how long does it take to tune a banjo? Nobody knows.
No me no.
No me no.
You see, they have those kind of funny overtones, which is why they say that, because, yeah, it's like, well, is that in tune or not? I don't know.
Well, it was in tune when he bought it. Some animal story he would tell. But oh, Charlie, I wonder now, just where did all the wise ones go? Did they leave us lie to live and die, watching the big wind river flow, watching the big brother and I went a-wandering way out through the pines, looking for stones and the angel bones only a young child finds. We got lost and scared as night fell in, but old Charlie tracked us down and carried us safe home in his arms with the moon. Thank you. Charlie, I'm lost again. Won't you come and track me down? Carry me back to the wilderness. Don't you let a good woman go down. Don't you let a good woman go down. Oh, and I did before the Great River was tamed.
I was going to just say that.
Yeah, that's such a gorgeous song.
She didn't do it just like I did, but she did a great version of it. Yeah.
Isn't that a killer song?
Did you see that? That is a great one. Well, I had another request that I promised I'd do, so I'm going to do this one.
I had 30 people ask me for Russell Coleman. If you do, why be so sure? Is that what you're going to do? Are you doing why be so sure?
What's that?
Are you doing why be so sure?
It's an old one of mine called Wide Open.
Okay.
Let's see. So I'm gonna have two sets of finger picks, and if I get them mixed up, ooh, it's gonna be trouble. So you know, I discovered that the reason they put these little bitty pockets in Levi's, you know, the little bitty ones up there, they're perfect for carrying a set of finger picks. You know, they just they just work great.
What are those little pockets for?
Well, it used to be for watches, I guess, but.
Oh, a pocket watch. Yeah, that's probably right.
Well, this is a song. It's also about. It's about the wonder of it all, the beauty of it all. You know, when you live in this beautiful place, and you know, you appreciate it, you enjoy it, but you know you also kind of numb out to it, and because if you were fully open to the beauty of and the wonder of it all you do is lay out there in the driveway and kind of twitch, you know, so you got to kind of block it out a little bit, and. But sometimes it seems like something sort of bends down and just peels the blinders off, and you just there's the thing that just goes, shoom, and you just go, poof. And that's what this song was about. It's called Wide Open. In a meadow, so that it could split me wide open. Like I ain't got no skin. Wide open. I just can't take it in. Wide open. Clear down the mountains to the gray cloud piled up so high. Rain on the sage perfumed like God's first breath. As the rainbow curves comes down, I swear it splits me wide open, like I ain't got no skin. Wide open, I just can't take it. To touch you, try to tell you how I feel. Then I see your eyes and I, there is no need. All this and more shining. I swear it splits me wide open to the seven seas and four winds. Wide open, I feel it take me in. Wide.
Thank you, thank you.
take a little journey down memory lane here with myself. This is the title song to my very first recording CD I put out. Actually, it was a cassette. That's how long ago it was. Later, it was printed onto CDs. But anyway, this was about my experience of being in Taos, loving New Mexico as I fell in love with it, as we talk about loving northern New Mexico, southern Colorado. This whole area is just like, it's just magic. And anyway, but at some point, as musicians, we have to make changes and go different places and, you know, go live in Nashville for a while or go be in LA for a while or whatever, wherever the wind takes us. So I'm gonna make a quick joke. I've carried this Eliza-ism for decades. So sometimes you live somewhere and you love it, but it's just not the right thing at that time. And so you have to make a change and go, and then as one door closes, another one opens and things happen. But Eliza put this very well one time. She says, when New Mexico's ready for you to leave, it just kind of spits you out.
You know what, I wish I could claim it, but even better is who I got it from.
Oh, okay.
Which was Tommy Hancock.
Tommy Hancock.
Supernatural Family Band, who lived in churches. Oh. The whole family lived without water in churches, and they were like, there's tapes of them, the whole family on acid up in churches. It was like, you know, praying like animals, and they're like, those people are so far out, but he was the one who said it with Tom. And Tommy was one of the, you know, all those Western guys that, everybody has an S, it's a whistling S. It's a very Western thing to have a whistling S. And when it's time to leave New Mexico, it spits you out. That's so funny that you remember that.
That's always stayed in my mind.
It's so true. It's like so time to go. That's right.
You know when it's time to go. Here's a song called Taos to Tennessee.
I've been on a one-way track. Guess there's no more looking back without you. I've known loneliness before. Here it's knocking at my door again. What's been done, what's been said? One love's gone and my head's all for leaving. Taos is home, but signs look good, and my mind's on that road to Tennessee. Western sky shining warm upon my back. Save a fiery setting sun for me. Misty eye needs a starry southern night. Shine a trail from Taos to Tennessee. Times are fast, dreams move slow. Nashville and New Mexico's the same. And if I could have my way, I'd take your love when I leave town today. Mountain sage, desert pine, how I hate to leave it all behind. Southern ways are new to me. For a song, it's where I long to be. Western sky shining warm upon my back. Save a fiery setting sun for me. Misty eye needs a starry southern night. Shine a trail from Taos, Tennessee. Shine a trail from Taos to Tennessee. You wanna play with it? western sky, shining warm upon my back. Save a fiery setting sun for me, misty eye needs a starry southern night to shine a trail from Taos to Tennessee. Shine a trail from Taos to Tennessee. Thank you.
Willie's going to do three, but can we do four?
Yeah, that's always the way I feel.
Yeah, is that a
too
cool?
Short.
Sure, sure.
I know. I just can't. I can't narrow it down to three. It's too hard.
Yeah. Okay, we'll finish this round and then do one more round.
That'll be our encore round.
So yeah, encore round, yeah.
Don moved over to make his selection.
We've done a video for this song that is very amusing. We went over to Cimarron with the Rifters and Rod Taylor very kindly let me ride his horse. You can imagine. What's really funny about the video is the guys are basically on the ground and they're kind of helping me get on the horse and get on down the road and then go to a bar and where we're singing this song. And I was watching Rod. My favorite part is when they finally get me on the horse and I take off. Rod's supposed to be looking at me, but he's so in love with his horse. It's so funny. He's just like looking at his horse. He's like, goodbye, Eliza. Whatever. There's my horse. It's so funny.
He was really pleased that Lucky was being a very good boy.
Lucky was really very tolerant of the things we asked of him.
The sun has slipped its face below the hills in the west. Here on the frontier, this is the time we love best. The breeze ripples the trees along the Rio Grande. Here is where we've made our last stand. Now don't stop loving me. Skin smells like the sage growing down by the stream. Please don't try to wake me, let me stay in this dream. We'll lie under the stars until the full moon appears, thankful for the wisdom of our years. Now don't stop loving me, baby, now don't stop. Don't stop loving me, baby, now don't stop.
Yeah.
satin sheets like bony maroni. Out there in the meadow stands my painted pony. Reminds me of a dream I had when I was a child. I'm gonna get up on that pony. I'm gonna ride, ride, ride. Don't stop loving me. Baby, now don't stop. Don't stop loving me. Baby, now don't stop. Don't stop.
This jazz guitar thing. We're gonna do one more round because we didn't want to. Yeah. We don't want to stop, baby.
Okay, so let's see. It's me this, to finish out the round, and then we do one more, right?
Right. That's right.
Getting a little dizzy all this round and round.
Yeah. Just fall right off our chairs.
I have a funny rod and horse story, too.
Oh, good. Let's hear it.
Well, since we're going to do one more round, I guess we could do Ruthie's request. You know, I could do Bristlecone. You could sing harmony with it. You want?
Oh, yeah, that's true. But I want...
Well, when it's my turn, I'll tell my rod story because it's funny.
All right.
Okay.
All right. I'll let Don have the stage.
Okay, well, were you going to do something?
She'll do it after you do your thing.
Okay.
We got a whole plan. The women have worked it out.
Oh, good. I depend on women to do that. I figure it out. What needs to happen. Okay, this is a song that Ruthie requested, and it's one I've loved singing for many years. Sometimes you hear a song from wherever, and you think, if you're a songwriter, that one was supposed to drop into my head, not that other guy. You know, I just felt like, oh, yeah, that just really resonated, and I've always loved this song, but it was actually written by a fellow named Hugh Prestwood, wonderful songwriter. And Eliza did do a just gorgeous version of the song on her record. But it has banjo in it, so it's even better.
Things go better with banjo.
Anyway, song about some of the oldest living things on the planet. They don't really know how old they are. They're just the ones that they've drilled into that they know, but... upwards of 4,000 years anyway, the bristlecone pines. There's a lot of them in the Sangre de Cristos. They're not, you know, this isn't where they grow that old, but, you know, who knows how old they are. There's a bunch of them up on, there's a whole little ghost forest of them up on Music Pass behind the sand dunes, mostly dead ones, but they're kind of, you know, spotted all over the Sangres at various altitudes. But I always love seeing them because it reminds me of the song. Way up in the mountains, on the high timber line, there's a twisted old tree called a bristlecone pine. The wind there is bitter, it cuts like a knife, and it keeps that tree holding on for dear life.
hold on thus, standing its ground, standing while empires rise and fall down. When Jesus was gathering lambs to his fold, the tree was already 1,000 years old. Now the way I've lived, there ain't no way to tell. When I die, if I'm going to heaven or hell. So when I'm laid to rest, it would suit me just fine. To sleep at the feet of a bristle. As I would slowly return to the earth, what little this body of mine might be worth would soon start to nourish the roots of that tree. And it won't partake of the essence of me. Knows that that is a century's turn. A small spark of me might continue to burn. As long as the sun did continue to shine down on the limbs of the bristle. The way I've lived, there ain't no way to tell. When I die, if I'm going to heaven or hell. So when I'm laid to rest, it would suit me just fine. To sleep at the feet of a bristle. Just as soon serve out eternity's time. Asleep at the feet of a bristle cocoon pine. Asleep at the feet of a bristle. Thank you, thank you.
Okay, so now we begin the final round here.
Here's our encore.
It would have been so hard for us to get up and walk over there and come back, so this is really important for us. Thank you so much.
Thank you too much.
Yeah, thank you too much.
I'm so going to take that.
So I'll tell the little Rod story. When we back when in the 90s, when we recorded in the Real West, we did a music video, and Rod was my cowboy in the video. And they tried to get me on a horse, and I'm not very good on horses. And so they did film a little point with me on the horse, but I was bouncing too much. But there's a really funny scene where Rod is actually helping me on the horse, and he's got his hand on my butt. And it's like, he told me that was the favorite part of the video.
You can still see it on YouTube.
It's on YouTube.
Really, look up in the Real West by Tish. And you'll see
Rod.
And
so finally, they just had me ride with him instead of me trying to ride my own horse. But
obviously, Rod has a thing with getting the girls on the horses now. I know. You see that now in the videos. Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Rod.
Thank you, Rod Taylor. So here's a song about the Rio Grande, and something that I really fell in love with. I followed the Rio Grande, and the Rio Grande has followed me for most of my life. And so here's a song called By the Rio Grande. Every river searches for the sea. Every life runs its own destiny. Story. Rio Grande runs south to Mexico. From the highway, I have touched his shore. Reynosa to Santa Fe and back the other way. I've had my life planned by the Rio.
Thank you.
yeah.
Thank you.
Here we are on the Rio Grande.
Thank you.
All right. Let's do At the Foot of the Mountain, huh?
Yeah.
We're going to do the song that the first song I wrote when I moved back to Taos. And it's like Tish and I are in parallel universes or something. But we, you know, we go and we come back and we go and we come back. And I'm in my comeback period. But, you know, when you, in Taos, and it's the same thing here, when you live at the foot of a mountain, you start to develop a really intimate relationship with the mountain. And so, you know, because we have an orchard and we have irrigation and we have to, you know, we really work to get water on there. And our water is completely dependent on what happens on that mountain. And so you have such an affection for the mountain. You have such a relationship with it. And so that's where this one came from. And did I do it in A? Or? Yeah, okay, good. Mr. Producer, help me. You good? All right. One, two, three.
Run down in the streams and the ditches that flow through the town. For the people who've lived there since time was unknown, the mountain is their home. At the foot of the mountain, they still work the land and they live in houses of mud and sand and give thanks to the spirit of water and stone where the mountain is their home. At the foot of the mountain they rise in the morn and they gather the apples and harvest the corn. The circle's unbroken when their children are born, where the mountain is their home. Thank you.
Richmond.
Yeah, Eliza Gilkyson. Yeah, it's a great song. Is this the last one?
This is it.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
Wrap it up.
Okay, well. I feel like I should do this song. It's a song about community, basically. And, you know, community is just this amazing thing. And I've always felt like we have an amazing community in Alamosa and the San Luis Valley. And, you know, the power of it is, the power of it is just amazing. I mean, there's a line in the song that, that basically, all the things that I don't know, somebody else will. I know somebody that knows that. I know somebody that knows how to do that, or fix it, or build it, or whatever. And it manifests in so many ways. And I've experienced it in so many ways. And we're experiencing it right now. We're here helping out. Helping out our neighbors, we're helping out a worthy cause, the San Luis Valley Cancer Relief Fund. You're helping out Society Hall every time you come here. Every interaction, really, it just weaves this web, you know, and that web holds us all up. And it makes it, not only holds us all up, it makes it a great place to live. And, you know, and I think that's a really important thing to remember. And, you know, one of the ways that I have experienced community, and this relates to this cause, back in 2007, I had stage 4 colon cancer. And I had a 5% chance of being alive in 5 years, according to statistics. And, you know, that was, let's see. Who's a good mathematician? Let's see. Yes, that's working on 15 years ago, you know. So, you know. So, and I tell you, one of the things that made the difference was community. You know, I mean, I had a lot of people pulling for me. You know, and then that does make a difference, and supporting me and doing these benefits and stuff. And it's like, you know, it's like, no, you don't need to do a benefit for me, you know, come on. But you know, it happened, and it was, they were incredible. So anyway, that's all somewhere in this little story of a song. It's called Me and Everybody I Know.
I love that song, Don.
It was a cold December morning. I should have been at work, but my plumbing had all frozen and my pipes all burst. I was sloshing round the basement in my rubber boots. Unmingled of it, ain't got a clue. Well, Billy came on over, cause he heard me. He said, I don't know what to do, but I know Jimmy will. Jimmy said, this guy, the torch we'll need. His shop is closed for Christmas, but I got the key. Yeah, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. Well, you can do it on your own, but from your day of birth to your headstone, it's your friends and neighbors that make it home. Yeah, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. I started thinking about way back when we built this house. I don't know what I can do, but I sure found out. With concrete and adobe and a bunch of friends who would show up for the work and stay until the end. You
put out the call and the answer comes from everywhere. From familiar places and some you don't even know are there. All that I don't know, I know someone else will. And one way or another we'll make it up the hill. Yeah, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. Oh, you can do it on your own, but from your day of birth to your headstone, it's your friends and neighbors that make it home. Yeah, me and everybody I know, me and everybody I know. Flat on my back in a hospital bed. It was hard to tell if I was alive or if I was dead. I had burned my candle to the ground, spark was gone. Try to remember why I'm here, why I should carry on. As thin as seeing light around me everywhere. Every message I received from someone who cared. I did a tiny tear. Oh, they raised me up like Lazarus. Now I'm so glad. Yeah, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. Oh, you can do it on your own, but from your day of birth or your marble stone, it's your friends and neighbors that make it home. Yeah, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. Yeah, me and everybody I know. Oh, me and everybody I know. Yeah, me and everybody I know.
Like all you folks, all y'all out there, as they say. Tish Hinojosa, Eliza Gilkyson, and Don Richmond, it's
an
honor and a pleasure to play for you anytime. Honor and a pleasure to be with these wonderful ladies here. Thank you all so much. Thanks for supporting the good causes. Thanks for making it happen. Love y'all. Thanks again. Thanks to San Luis Valley Cancer Relief Fund and all the folks there and the board of Society Hall, but most of all,